Mark Zuckerberg is betting it all on the metaverse, but his empire is crumbling like dry toast. That's because since Facebook was rebranded to Meta, its stock has plummeted more than 60%. In the summer of 2021, the company was worth just under $1 trillion. Today, it's down to just $300 billion. Okay, now compared to your bank account, that probably doesn't sound like that little. But to put that in perspective, the last time the stock was this low was in 2016. And the outlook for Meta is not great. Hundreds of blog posts and YouTube videos predict Meta's demise. But why? Monetizing apps through advertising is becoming increasingly difficult, especially on Apple's iPhone. And Instagram and Facebook seem to be losing touch with the young generation, which is increasingly active on TikTok. And Mark Zuckerberg's pet project, the Metaverse, is considered by many to be a joke. And hardly anyone seems to really use the Metaverse.
The most popular part of the Metaverse is probably Decentraland, and it only has about 379 daily active users.
I was wondering, can a company innovate it too radically? Most companies are too comfortable and playing it too safe. Especially European companies are good at preserving the old, but mostly fail at reinvent themselves. In 1997, Professor Clayton Christensen published the book The Innovator's Dilemma. It's a clever analysis of why large established companies repeatedly fail to assess disruptive forces and therefore usually adapt too late to disruptive change. Christensen's hypothesis? A new technology is inferior at the beginning and is therefore underestimated by many, especially the established market players. However, when it proves itself, the new technology enters a phase of rapid growth, then becomes unbeatable and displaces the old. Zuckerberg finds himself in exactly this innovator's dilemma. But he stumbles not because he failed to recognize new technologies, but because some things went unfortunately, and also because he makes some big mistakes. But more on that later. Meta includes the popular apps Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp. They all use the mobile internet. Meta's Reality Labs, which is developing smart glasses, VR devices, and the metaverse, on the other hand, could be the new wave Zuckerberg wants to ride. Zuckerberg is aware that this change won't come overnight. Zuckerberg's dream is an immersive kind of internet where people come together to spend time, work, play, and buy things. But why is Zuckerberg betting everything on this future? This becomes clear when we look at the history of Facebook. Facebook has been successful so far because they've made the leap from PC to mobile, whether by developing their own apps or through acquisitions. When Zuckerberg spent the staggering sum of $1 billion in 2012 to acquire a tiny 13-person startup called Instagram, many people scratched their heads. But the acquisition was to become one of the most lucrative in tech history. Experiences, positive and negative, shape our thinking. But this time, Zuckerberg isn't just focusing on software only. He wants to control the interface of the future. Control over the hardware will allow him to build the platform, dictating the rules of the game and for what the digital world will look like in the future. Today, the interface is controlled by Google and Apple. Apple takes 15 to 30% of subscriptions and in-app purchases of all apps and also creates huge unfair advantages for itself. For example, with Apple Music by better integrating the service with Apple's hardware. Amazon and Facebook have each launched their own smartphones with the goal of cutting out the middleman and getting direct to the customer. But both players had to realize that they were too late to the party. Their phones flopped big time. This round, Zuckerberg wants to be first.
We believe the metaverse will be the successor to the mobile internet.
But why might his strategy fail? Basically, Zuckerberg's strategy isn't stupid. Facebook's and Instagram's advertising business is funding the development of hardware and software for the metaverse until augmented and virtual reality are established as a new dominant design. But its strategy could fail, and right now it looks like it will. Apple has been working behind the curtain on VR and AR since the early 2000s. But in typical Apple fashion, they won't launch anything until they're quite sure it will delight people. But when it does, Apple has shown time and again that they can take over a market very quick. At the same time, Apple is already turning off the money tap to Meta. Since April 2021, iPhone users have been able to ban app tracking. The official reason is that this will allow iPhone users to better protect their privacy. But since this change, Meta has lost billions in advertising budget. Add to that the overall tough economy and the downturn after the brief pandemic boom in e-commerce, and you have an explosive mix. For Meta, this is already painful. In November 2022, they announced that they would be laying off 11,000 employees. But Apple isn't the only competitor working on augmented and virtual reality that will make life difficult for Zuckerberg in the coming years. Microsoft also wants to push into this potential business. And Microsoft has two strategic advantages over Meta. First, Microsoft has its foot in the door with pretty much all the big companies with Teams, Windows, and Office products. The second advantage? They've bought a lot of game studios over the last 20 years and have a lot of experience with the gaming market with Xbox. And in early 2022, it was announced that Microsoft wants to acquire Activision Blizzard for $69 billion. The FTC is currently trying to stop this acquisition. However, if it succeeds, it would be Microsoft's biggest acquisition in the company's history. But why is this so dangerous for Zuckerberg? Gaming is currently the most important use case for virtual reality, and next to business communication, the second strategy to bring VR and AR headsets among the people. And through this acquisition, Microsoft could then make popular titles such as Call of Duty exclusively available to Microsoft's VR worlds. But competition from Apple, Microsoft, and maybe other players isn't the only risk to Zuckerberg's strategy. Another problem is timing. Predicting the future is not easy. I already made a video about this, showing how Apple had already tried to build a smartphone in the late 80s. You can watch the video here. No one can predict the future accurately. For example, what if the metaverse comes, but not for another 10 or 20 years? Then the gap between today's cash cows, Instagram and Facebook, and the cash cow of the future, the metaverse, will become too big. On the Gartner hype cycle, which rates the maturity of new technologies, virtual reality has moved from here in 1995 to here in 2015. In other words, almost not at all. In the same period, how we interact with the internet has moved from this here to this. But aside from the fact that virtual and augmented reality may take longer to become mainstream than Zuckerberg would like, it is also possible that this technology will never catch on in a big way. People, especially innovators, often suffer from pro-innovation bias. In the 1950s, for example, people assumed that in the future, every engine and appliance would be powered by a mini nuclear reactor. And even in the 1970s, the US Atomic Energy Commission predicted that by the turn of the 21st century, 1,000 reactors would be producing electricity in the United States. But this never happened. Today, there are less than 100 commercial reactors in the United States. Perhaps even the metaverse will remain a niche product for gaming and a few other limited applications. Elon Musk, for example, can't imagine virtual reality playing a major role in the near future.
I don't see someone strapping a friggin' screen to their face all day. And not wanting to ever leave. It seems no way. Yeah. I mean, does it feel like that to you? It doesn't seem like that to me.
Yeah. Zuckerberg still has one or two aces up his sleeve. One possible advantage is that he's betting everything on the metaverse. He's thus pursuing the no plan B strategy. Many successful people like Quentin Tarantino or Arnold Schwarzenegger have repeatedly said in interviews how important it was for them to put all their eggs in one basket. The second ace is a technical innovation. Eye tracking could bring fundamental progress to virtual reality. Our eyes only see a very small portion in focus, but current VR devices don't take advantage of that. The entire field of view is rendered in the same resolution, which requires very powerful hardware that drives up cost and weight. The resolution of today's VR devices may look disappointing, but it's actually higher than the resolution of modern 4K displays, because the field of view is very large. Eye tracking could be the breakthrough here, since only the part you are looking at needs to be in high resolution. The computational power could be saved massively as a result. We are therefore probably closer to photorealistic VR than many think possible. The technology that seems inferior today could be superior tomorrow and maybe here to stay. And Zuckerberg has a third ace up his sleeve, and that's WhatsApp. WhatsApp has 2 billion active users today, but is hardly monetized so far. But that could soon change, especially with WhatsApp for Business. If Zuckerberg can do that without losing users, he may be able to fund the augmented and virtual reality revolution, even if it may take a few years longer than planned. But is that enough of a reason to blow the victory march for Meta? No, because Zuckerberg is making two crucial psychological mistakes. One big mistake is that he's letting down those who are elemental to a leap in innovation, innovators and early adopters. These are the people who try new things and are willing to overlook minor mistakes and difficulties. But they only do that if they are really excited about some other aspects of the innovation. So far, the enthusiasm is mostly missing. Meta has not yet succeeded in translating the innovations from the lab into new commercial products. Everything that Meta's reality labs has brought to market so far seems somehow immature. The second flaw is Zuckerberg's performance. Yes, we all know that he's not the most charismatic guy. And the internet is full of jokes that Mark Zuckerberg is in fact a robot. But it's not so much Zuckerberg's weird demeanor. Even other tech billionaires are kind of weird sometimes. But the fact that he has a very strong seller frame that is concerning. It seems like he has to convince the whole world that the metaverse is the future.
I think it's actually pretty good on a lot of expressions. I mean, you can like, moving your mouth around, like, I mean, moving it from side to side. You can even like puff your cheeks, like.
You can literally smell his neediness. We see in the next few years how Meta evolves and whether Zuckerberg might end up being the one who loves last. In my opinion, it would be desirable for our society to have an open metaverse that is not dominated by one big IT player. Well, you can still dream, can't you? If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up. And if you want to learn more about the psychology of innovation, then what are you waiting for? Quickly subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.